Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you 10 different Buddhist locations across the world. I realized that I have traveled to many Buddhist locations across the world and I have chosen 10 locations which are favorite of mine. And before I start, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. That motivates me to do more videos of similar kind. And now let's begin.
White Temple or Watrang Khun is a Buddhist temple in North Thailand in Chiang Rai.
It was built by a passionate architect. In fact, it is still under construction. It will go on for a few more years. He has a very big picture in his mind. It is completely white in color. They have used glass work on the external facade of the building, which reflects, it shimmers and looks beautiful. There is a small pool outside this temple and they have used like many superheroes of today's, like Harry Potter. They are trying to show that within us there is a demon. That concept can be seen across the temple. Very unique, very different, and even the washroom is very ornate. It is made in kind of a golden design. Everything looks golden. Exterior of the washroom also looks very golden structure. This white they have used because white symbolizes purity of Buddha.
Next one in my list is Perfume Pagoda. It belongs to 15th century. It's a vast complex of Buddhist temples and shrines built into the limestone Phuong Thich Mountains of Vietnam.
It's not quite famous. Only locals go there. During my visit, we could hardly find any Indians or any other foreigners there. But more than the architecture or historical importance, what I liked was the traveling time itself was so much fun because I had to go by a road, then take a boat, then cable car, and then I had to hike for some distance. So it's so much fun and it's very scenic. All around you can see a lot of mountains.
It's a pilgrimage place for Buddhist Vietnamese. Traveling with pilgrims is an experience by itself. And the beauty of the mountains around is not to be missed. There are shrines inside the caves as well.
Ayutthaya in Thailand, it is dates back to 13th century. It is very close to Thailand's capital Bangkok. It's not very hard to find this place. It is an archaeological site which has got many ruins and many Buddhist temples and monasteries in that complex. It's very beautiful. Wherever we go, we see one or the other Buddha image that gives us a kind of a very different experience.
Paying homage to 9 temples here in Ayutthaya is considered to be very good.
Key Monastery in India in Spiti Valley. It is a 11th century monastery. It is a living monastery even today. It is located in Spiti Valley around Stark Mountains. This one structure which is in white color is something that looks stunningly beautiful. It is a living monastery where 250 monks are living and learning. It has many murals and Buddha images inside. Dabo Monastery in Spiti area in India is also one of my favorite because it is a very ancient monastery. It goes back to 10th century. The structure is very simple. It is kind of outside structure. You can see it is in mud. Very, very, very simplest one among all the temples that I listed. But inside, it has got many murals and many paintings. It is called as Ajanta of Himalayas in Spiti Valley. There are many caves around this temple where earlier monks used to practice their meditation. When I visited, the spiritual head Rinpoche was arriving that day to this temple and many villagers were standing and welcoming him. And it was a spiritual experience to join them, welcoming him and listening to his lectures. Tiger's Nest are Taksang Monastery in Bhutan. Bhutan is my favorite place and this monastery is located in Paro, which is the capital of Bhutan. It is perched on top of the cliff. You to reach there, the only way is to walk. You have to climb. It takes around 2 to 2.5 hours to go up to this monastery. It depends on one's speed and the energy that they can walk up to this monastery. From outside, though it looks very simple, but inside it is very beautiful with many paintings, tanka paintings and paintings on the wall. Whoever goes to Bhutan, their visit is not complete unless they visit Tiger's Nest Monastery. Zhuangkang Monastery in Datang region of China. This goes back to 5th century. I have already made a video about it. If you want, you can click the I card above and I am going to leave the link in the description as well. This is called as Hanging Monastery because it doesn't stand on any surface. It is actually built on the walls of the cliff itself. So you don't see the foundation, where it is, how it is supported properly. You see that as if the entire monastery is hanging in the middle of the air. It is around 75 meters above the ground level. It's very scary when we walk on the floor.
Zhuangkang Monastery is listed as one of the dangerous buildings in the world.
Saranath is in very much in India. It is one of the more tourist place because it is very close to Varanasi, around 10 kilometers from Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. Saranath is also part of Buddha's trials in India. He taught the Dharma when he visited Saranath after his enlightenment. And our Ashoka Stambha also was found here in Saranath. It is still in the museum there. It is also an archaeological park and there is a small temple as well. This is one of the very significant Buddhist place in India. Of course, Sanchi. It is one of the oldest stupa that we can see in India. It was built by Ashoka. It is a very significant place, not only for Buddhist enthusiasts, but also history enthusiasts as well. It has many carvings on the surface. Many other Buddhist places, they have monuments, they have Buddha images, but this is the place where Buddha's teachings are carved in inscriptions around the stupa. And the final one is Bodh Gaya. It is one of the major pilgrimage place for Buddhists. This is the place where Buddha got his enlightenment. In this Mahabodhi society complex, we can find temple for Buddha as well as the tree under which Buddha got enlightenment. Not only that, there are many other locations where after enlightenment, where Buddha sat, he was staring at the Bodhi Ruksha. There is another place where he was sitting and he was under meditation.
There are quite a few places within the complex which are related to Buddha, how he spent his time after enlightenment for next 7 weeks.
Yeah, I think that's it for today. Hope you like the video. Let me know which is your favorite place. Whenever you get a time, please do visit to these places. They are worth a visit. See you next time with another video. Until then, bye-bye.